And that brings me very interestingly to Ishi. Ishi, please be ready with an answer to, because what you are doing is bringing what women have been doing for years into the field of professional nurturing care for all. And I'd like you to respond to the audience here about the kind of challenges you must have faced when you took it upon yourself to do something different and differently. Ishi, over to you.
Thank you, Brijendra, for having me. And this is an opportunity to share very special parts of our journey. As a child, I think I'll just begin with the background of why I'm doing what I'm doing, and then maybe specifically answer your question.
Sure.
I was an obese child, and I think I connected with childhood obesity at a very subconscious level. It never really bothered me consciously. Nobody ever said anything to me, but it must be something which happened to me in class, I would say 7 or 8, when you have to decide your career path. And I had always thought initially that I'll do medicine, but when around that time I started losing weight on my own, I did my own little things, which I realized were very empowering. They made a transformation in my personality, in the way I was looking, on my skin, my confidence. And that was a turning point in class 10 when I decided that this seems like far more exciting than just medicine. So I did not apply for a single medical college and went straight and applied for the nutrition course in Lady Irwin at Delhi University. And that was the only form I filled because it was so clear in my head that I wanted to heal through food. I wanted to make that difference. And I was already beginning to make my inroads into information seeking, reading books, and applying it within the family, with friends, etc. So that was the journey where it started. And after completion of my master's in Lady Irwin, I just did some hospital jobs, etc. And when I was in Escorts, I was dealing with heart patients, and I was dealing with a lot of other comorbidities, which are a part of heart disease, including obesity, diabetes, hypertension, etc., etc. And that's when I realized that, here it is so easy for me to advise people to eat this and not eat this, or eat less fat or eat better fat and eat less processed food or better flours, etc., etc. Eat amla. In those days, in 2001, even amlas were really not things which people knew what they were. It was very sad. So I saw this huge gap in what needed to be done, what needed to be made available to people to make my work more meaningful, and what there was in the market already. It was all processed and laden with trans fats, bad fats, the oily namkeens, refined flours, etc. So when I was talking to my patients and I wanted this change in their diets, I felt very incomplete and almost inadequate, almost dishonest, that I know these are not going to be easily possible for this individual. And that dishonesty, or that feeling of not being able to help completely, you can do lip service, but you clearly cannot make that difference. And if the person is indeed motivated to make that difference, it is challenging. It takes a lot of time for a housewife or a working woman to put those things together. And that kind of churned inside me for years while I was working at Escorts. And somewhere down the line, I shared this discontentment in my work with first Dr. Trehan, who was my boss, and then with my own family. My father-in-law was a diabetic who connected with what I, wanted to do. And then it was obvious that I had to put a health food company in place. I had to make these available, and I took it upon myself. In the year 2001, with the help of my husband. So I really cannot say that it was entirely me. It was hardly me. It was my family support which enabled me to do what I am doing. The business part of it is very different, very difficult, and I am a very professional kind of a mindset. So I needed that input from the family, and my husband had that background. So it was it was a combination. So I will really never say that, it was my area. It was both. And I also believe that women and men should really stop doing this in the, man versus woman. They are so complementary. One without the other are not complete. We know it at different levels. We know it at yin and yang. We know it, the energies are different when you are in a setup or trying to do something. We need both. And so that's how my journey began into the health food space, where, again, it was totally organic. It was a response to the need. And that need was being fulfilled, and it just grew organically. We did not have budgets, advertising budgets to, expand, in those days. But it was just perhaps, I also believe there is always an idea whose time has come. And I think it was perhaps just that, and which led to, it just growing from one to the other, strength to strength. And when we opened health food cafes in hospitals, we were asked to do that. And so there was really no stopping, and one hospital and the other hospital reached out, and then corporates reached out, and, it was pan India. It was just growing. And apart from that, then I also felt that people were not that aware. And therefore, my books happened, and the writings happened, and lots of, write from a book on cholesterol and the book on obesity, the diet doctor. So the awareness also with my columns was a part of what I did to make it more complete, because there is a lot of misinformation and myths around food. And then there was a whole new chapter, a new learning in my career path. At around that time, which was to do with wheat sensitivity. And at that time, gluten and celiac disease were really not words which were familiar with public and even the medical fraternity. And it was a personal story in the family where we realized that there was food sensitivity, celiac disease, which went unnoticed, undiagnosed. And this was something which I had felt about this person, and it was just not being recognized. And I realized if the top doctors in the country and the top names in the best, in gastroenterology, pediatrics, et cetera, were not able to pinpoint how the gap existed in the rest of our country, in the rest of the world. So again, it was really a response to the need. And I said, one has to create awareness and about wheat sensitivity. It is seemingly the cause of so many things today that we are seeing as epidemics. Whether it is anemia, whether it is, I think every disease today, modern research, there's a paper which was just published in January where this scientist has said almost all diseases begin in the gut and leaky gut, which is related to food sensitivities. And so we have come a long way in the last decade or two decades, I would say, with respect to research. And I started my the Celiac Society of India in the year 1996, simply to create this awareness. And today I would say people understand it far more, people are dealing with it, yet there is a lot more that needs to be done. And the idea was to create awareness also and support these people who have issue with wheat or similar grains or other food sensitivities to sort of get the options and to be able to live normally and healthy lives. It's very nice to say, gehu mat khao, lekin khao ke kya? That is the next question. So it was by sheer chance that I had a health food company, and we began, producing those foods to cater to that need. So pretty much literally, it has been one thing to the other. And I would say it's been very gratifying. And today I feel the power of food, which I felt as a child, really seems to be at a different level, where we are able to, treat diseases, reverse diseases, right from mental health to physical health, and your skin and the hair and everything. So it's been quite a journey, and I would say the lessons to be learned are that one needs to be sincere, and one needs to be having the right attitude, and one needs to, just to make that difference should be very, very, it should be real. It should just not be theoretical. One needs to be practical in life. Whatever one says to somebody, one in my profession, one has to understand that we are dealing with people. And for me, I think for my job requires both the science and the art put together. So thank you.
Lovely. Yeah, thank you. You know, what you bring out is the wisdom of mothers and women for millennia have now been brought up to the modern day's requirements adapted by you. And you're very right. The balancing of the feminine and the masculine energies within all of us. Yeah. But to do that, all of those who have held positions of power have had to take the first steps to first create an equal, because without equal, there is no complementarity.